Hello everyone. In this video, we will see the concept of neobase classifier. We will see the probability basics, then types of probabilistic models, probabilistic classification, and neobase algorithm with the example. To understand the probability basics, we say that we have various probability concepts like prior probability, conditional probability, join probability, or random variables. So prior probability is probability of P of X, we say. So it is a fixed probability, which is a prior probability. The conditional probability, we have probability of two variables, probability of x1 upon x2 or probability of x2 upon x1. In case of join probability, we have probability of two variables x1 comma x2, which is a probability of x total vector x1 and x2. And the relationship, if we see with the conditional probability and join probability, we have probability of x1 comma x2 is equal to actually probability of x2 upon x1 into probability of x1. Or we can say that probability of x1 upon x2 into probability of x2. So here we can find the joint probability as either of the conditional probability multiplied by the prior probability, self probability itself. Now the independent variables, we have probability of x1 upon x2, that is equal to probability of x2, probability of x1 upon x2 is probability of x1, and so on. So we say that independent of the independence of random variables, we have in that we based on the only single probability values. Now for this purpose, we have one rule which is called as a Bayesian rule, and here we have probability of C by X, that is probability of a particular class for a given attribute X, is actually positive probability, which is a probability of X by C multiplied by probability of C divided by probability of X. So here we have the positive probability, which is based on the likelihood probability, then we have the evidence probability, and then we have the prior probability, which is probability of C over here. So we can find out the C by X, the probability, positive probability based on the prior likelihood and the evidence probabilities. To understand this, we have two types of probabilistic models, as we see, the discriminative and generative probabilistic models. The discriminative probabilistic models are based on the positive probability distribution, while the generative models are based on the joint probability distribution. So just now we have seen what is the positive probability and joint probability. So they are actually the basis for these probabilistic models. The classification models like KNN, decision trees, perceptron, SVM, all are typically based on the rule directly. So they are the discriminative models, and the probabilistic model like the neobase classifier is a generative model. As the name says, generative model, it always generates the new instances and find the probability of new instances. Let us see about these two models in the next slides. So we have the discriminative model as the first type of model. Here we see that we have a discriminative probabilistic classifier, which is a common classifier for all these instances, for all the attributes X, and we find probability of C by X for all these class labels as a probability from this discriminative probabilistic model, which is based on the posterior probability. While if you see the generative probabilistic models, we have the separate classifier for these classes. Every class has a separate classifier, and this model is generating the total probability, probability of X by C for every class label C and for all the attributes X1 to Xn. So here, to understand this, we say there is a map decision rule over here. In this map decision rule, we call this as a maximum a posterior probability. So here, we assign the X to this C star, the class label, which is a maximum probability value. As the name suggests, maximum a posterior probability. And here we can apply this map to this generative classification model based on this posterior probabilities. So probability of C by X is actually based on probability of X by C, probability of C, and probability of X. So as we just now seen in the Bayesian rule, that is implemented over here, and whichever is a maximum, that is called as a maximum a posterior probability. Now to understand this, we have to see a classifier which is a very famous, which is a neobase classifier. So here the base classification, we say that the probability of C by X is actually the probability of X by C into probability of C. So we find out these all probability, posterior probability values from the joint probability values, that is probability of X1 to Xn. So as we already see that neobase classifier is a generative model over here, so it is based on the joint probability values. So it's very difficult to learn the joint probability values. Finally, we should implement this using posterior and prior probability values. So in this case, to find the probability of all these x1 to xn for a particular class C, we find the individual probabilities, probability of x1 by C into probability of x2 by C into probability of xn by C for every class we have every attribute values, and then we apply the map decision rule to find out the maximum probability multiplied by the probability of C. So here we find out the joint probability values, then multiply the class value probability, and then we find the total probability using the naive Bayes rule. So in our total, we can say we have to apply the Bayes rule first of all, and then we have to apply the map decision rule to find out the class label for a given instance. We can say that there are two phases for this naive Bayes algorithm. The first is the learning phase, where we find the conditional probabilities considering the each attribute and each value for all the class labels, and we have the testing phase, where we find the conditional probability using naive Bayes rule, and we find out the class label using map decision rule, which is a maximum a posterior probability rule. Here we see one example to play the tennis, yes or no. So considering the four attributes, the outlook, temperature, humidity and wind. For the outlook, we have sunny, overcast and rain as the three values. For the temperature, we have hot and mild, cool, three values. And for humidity, we have the high and normal. For wind, we have weak and strong as the values. So we say that there is a combination of these values to find out the play tennis. Now to underestimate this classifier, we have this learning phase and the testing phase. So first of all, applying the learning phase, we see that the outlook has three values, sunny, overcast and rain. So we find these probabilities for the both classes, yes and no. Using this table, we can easily find these values. Then for temperature, hot, mild and cool, we have again play tennis, yes and no. So we can find out number of records for this yes and number of records for the no as a class label considering the three values. Again for humidity, we have the high and normal two values. So we can find out this play tennis, yes and no, for this high normal humidity values. And for the wind, strong and weak values, we have play tennis, yes no. We can easily find these two values. So here the prior probability play yes is 9/14 and play no is 5/14. So easily we can find these tables. Now the second phase, the testing phase, where we have given a particular instance, we have given the values for the attributes like outlook is sunny, temperature is cool, humidity is high, wind is strong. Then we have to approximate the class or estimate the class for this particular instance. So here, first of all, as we have already find out this, the learning phase over here. From this learning phase, we can find these values. The probability of outlook is equal to sunny, play is equal to yes. From the first table, we have this as a 2/9, and outlook sunny, play is equal to no, 3/5. Similarly, we find for temperature, humidity, wind, for class yes as well as class no from the previous table. Then the play yes, we know the probability, prior probability is 9/14, and play no probability is 5/14. So using all these values, we can apply the Bayes rule as well as the map decision rule to find out the class label. So here probability of getting the class label yes for given instance x dash is probability of individual this conditional probabilities multiplied by the class probability play is equal to yes. So we can find this multiplication to be 0.0053, and for the no class we find the probability of sunny no, and then cool, high, strong with the probability of this class play no multiplication, this equal to 0.0206. So we see that considering this class yes and no, we get the maximum value using the map decision rule, which is a no class. So we say that the conditions sunny, cool, high, strong are saying that the play tennis should be no. So we can estimate the class label using these probability values. To summarize all this, what we say is that the naive Bayes is based on the condition independence. It is based on independence of the every attribute values. So the training is very easy and fast, and just require the considering each attribute and each class separately. That just now we have seen with the example, separate tables are generated for every attribute value and every class. Then the testing also very straightforward. It is just looking up the tables and calculating the conditional probabilities with the estimated distributions. So that is the beauty of this naive Bayes classifier. It makes it very easy to understand this naive Bayes classifier. Then we say that it's a very popular generative model, because the performance is competitive to most of the state-of-the-art classifiers that we already see as discriminative classifiers, and they are even in presence of violation of independence assumption, still we can use this as a very easy classifier. Then many successful applications we can implement, like spam mail filtering, image classification, we can make use of this naive Bayes classification. Also, We can say the Navier's classifier can be easily used for the ensemble learning, which is a hybrid approach for classification, and we can easily integrate this with the other classifiers. So this is all about this Navier's classifier. Thank you.